Good day, everyone. This is Zoe, and you are now listening to MI Radio's Learning Hub program, which is all about discussing different perspectives, variety of topics while focusing on daily usage of the English language. And we got Leo.
Hello, everyone. Hello, my friends. So Learning Hub DBTV is a collaboration project between American University of Yangon, AUI for short. In fact, we have guests from AUI today. Hello, you guys. Please introduce yourselves. So glad to have you guys.
Hello, my name is Thierry Minton, and I'm from the American University of Yangon as a graduate.
Hello, everyone. My name is Felicio. I'm an Exner Program Officer at American University of Yangon.
Thanks for coming today. So I'm curious what brings you guys here today and what we're going to talk about. I'm ready to join.
Yeah.
Today we're here to talk about the white lies we used to hear from our parents when we were kids.
Oh, all right. Okay, so a lot to unpack, you guys. There's so much to talk about.
Yes.
So, yeah.
So, me too. I've got mouthful of things to spill about.
Of course.
How about you?
It's a lot. My parents used to tell me lots of white lies, and I ended up being really paranoid. So yes, I also have a lot to talk about. Yeah. MI Radio,
living the life you love. So there are so many nonsense white lies that I've encountered in my entire lifetime. So Philly, I'm sure you have a personal story about white lies and well-intentioned falsehoods. Like, they were told by someone you know, and maybe someone you love. You can spit it out.
Sure. Most of the white lies I used to hear are coming from my parents.
Uh-huh.
And the way...
Exactly.
Yeah. Exactly.
I think just like anyone else in this room, we used to hear the when it's about... You've got to eat all of the food on your plate.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't eat all that food from your plate, then you are going to make your parents or your family poor.
Oh,
exactly. I heard a lot.
It's extreme, though.
So how about your theory? Yeah. Everyone's listening.
Yeah, you know, you're clearly younger than all of us. So.
Mm. Yeah, so of course, since I haven't gone too far into adulthood yet, and the main sort of white lies that I've encountered are, of course, the ones with my parents.
Mm-hmm.
It's a long story, actually. I was, I think, 6, 7 years old around that time. And my mom and my nanny, they would always take me where we would just go shopping for groceries, and I would always go across the toy aisle just looking at things, touching them a little bit. And so the white lie that my mom told me was that if you touch any of those toys, because I broke one of them before, but if you touch any of those toys, oh, you see those mannequins over there? Oh yeah, they're gonna come alive and they're gonna eat you up and turn you into one of them. And I was so scared. I could never leave my nanny's side. I would always hold her hand and just follow my mom around.
Actually, it was really funny. By the way, I used to talk to my nephews and nieces with white lies too. Like, if you don't eat your food well, the boogeyman will come.
Oh my god.
Please forgive me, it's too bad.
I don't want to be your niece or nephew.
Thank you.
Mm.
But it's like the bad consequences of the white lie customs from generation to generation. Because my mom and my older sister used to communicate with me using a white lie. So even though they employed white lies for well-intentioned reason, I feel that honesty should have been approach, right?
Mm.
So, could you tell me about your childhood experiences have influenced your views on, like, honesty and parenting as teacher?
Mm. I think it have a great impact on my life.
Mm-hmm.
First, if I didn't listen to my parents telling me white lies,
right?
At some point, I would say that I would have been in trouble, right?
Yes,
and they
yes.
know that it's just to scare, to prevent their kids from doing or committing something dangerous.
Yes, yes.
Right? So I think it's influenced a lot. And the reason that I would say why I'm here, the way I'm here today, I think it's also because of the white lies was influenced greatly in my life.
Mm.
Yeah, but when you look back to that time, it was like, oh, that was a lie.
Yeah. You are listening to the Learning Hub DBTV program. Hello, my beautiful friends. So, Zue,
Hi.
What kind of white lies have your parents? I know you grew up with a lot of sisters. Uh-huh. Your relatives, what have they told you while growing up? I'm curious because I know you and you're you, so.
Okay, so I have a story.
Of course, okay.
When I was young, I used to talk back at my parents. By the way, not in the rude way. Mm-hmm. I will just be explaining to them I was not doing the wrong thing. So, every time I talk back to my mom, she would be like, you might get struck by lightning. Mm. So, that's why even though I was right in some of the arguments with my mom, I would just zip my mouth and say nothing because it's too obvious I'm afraid. So right now I'm 25, I'm still afraid to get struck by lightning. That's the consequences. So because of this kind of situation, do you develop trust issue with your parents or like, are these white lies, how can I say, harmless?
Yeah, for me, it's generally, I like to think it's generally harmless, except for the fact that, well, I guess similar to your case, I've gotten quite paranoid of things where I would be so obsessed with perfectionism because of these, even though these superstitions or these white lies or whatever, they are quite lighthearted. It sort of sticks in like one of the deeper parts of my childhood, and it affects me maybe just a little bit.
Mm. So harmless but effective.
Yeah.
How about you, Leo? I have a story, I know. You have a story, I know.
So, when I was younger, I would usually nap after I eat. And I love to eat, as you can clearly see, right?
No complaint.
Shush. And so I would fall asleep after I eat, and my mom would always be like, you're going to turn into a snake. You're going to be a snake. And clearly, I'm not a snake. I'm still human, right? So, I mean, at this point in my life, at 28, I would love to be a snake.
What's the reason? No work?
No work, just in the jungle somewhere.
Don't forget to take me there.
No, I won't, of course.
Yeah. So if you have plans alive, like having kids one day, would you do the same thing? And will you tell the white lines to then?
Or do you have nieces or nephews that you have that you're kind of doing the same thing your parents did?
Of course, I think I would do the same.
Right, yeah. Okay.
I think this is the best way to control your kids.
In an honest
and a positive way, right?
Oh, okay. Mm, yes. All right.
Okay, so right now let's talk about the modern white lines. Everyday white lines we hear these days. So for example, I have a friend who is always late all the time. Every time I call him, he will be like, I'm on my way, I'm on my taxi. But in reality, he's still in the shower or something like doing stupid. Maybe he thinks he's telling a few white lies, not intending to hurt me. However, on the other side, the trust between us seems to have decreased. So, because I have not been trusting him lately.
You guys are friends. You're not enemies, right?
Yes, yeah. I believe we are just friends, not enemies, like you said before. And we should be honest with each other, right? So you guys want to share any stories about that?
Like modern white little lies that we tell each other every day. It's like, hey, I'm coming, but I'm still in the shower, you know, something like that.
Yeah. Yeah. I think we just did it a few minutes ago.
Yeah. Did we?
Yeah, if we're going to talk about modern times, I think compliment culture is a big thing. Whenever you meet someone new, especially... when I'm like interacting with someone that doesn't know anything about me and they want to befriend me, they would always start off with an, oh my god, you're so pretty. Really?
But you are pretty.
Aww.
You are pretty.
See, it's happening right now. Something like that.
All right. Okay, yeah. So compliment culture. Okay.
Yeah. Mm. Like you're trying to encourage and motivate other people, right?
Yes.
Even though their performance, doesn't meet your expectation, but in a way, you're trying to motivate them to keep them moving forward. Then you have to do something, say something, right?
Right.
Yeah. You did a great job.
Bad place. Yeah.
You did the best. Mm.
Hi, my friends. You're listening to the Learning Hub DBTV program on MI Radio. Hello. So, Theory.
Yes.
Hello. So, what can you tell me about like modern white lies or like a white lie that you have told recently? Like anything that you want to share? Like,
if we're talking about a white lie that I've recently done, it's something to do with a friend. You see, my friend, let's call them they for now, just for privacy's sake. They tend to have a lot of crushes, you see, and oftentimes when they try to approach their crushes, it's often quite ends up being quite awkward, but then, you know, when you're their friend, right, you gotta be nice and supportive about them, and so whenever they have their little attempts, little reckless attempts of trying to flirt, even when they come off as totally creepy, you have to keep supporting them, like, oh, it's okay, you're doing so well, yes, good job for the initiative, whoa. You just have to keep supporting them so that they do better in the future, even though you don't really.
Okay.
I did a love, even though I knew since the beginning they are going to break her lately.
Oh, really?
Oh, no. Oh, my
God.
Oh,
gosh. Okay. But wouldn't that be harmful? Like,
I mean,
you're giving them hope.
I mean, you're giving them hope, but in turn, you know, they're going to learn from the experience that they have with this current person that they're trying to approach them. And they're going to learn by themselves. You know, I'm not going to risk my relationship with that person so just so that they can learn. They can learn from other people.
Maybe we love to watch some drama.
Oh my gosh, are you one of those people that just like does that?
Sadly, no.
Let's talk about compliment culture. That's a little bit, it has something to do with white lies, right? Do you have anything you want to share on compliment culture,
Capella? Sure.
Uh-huh.
There's complimentary, you know, white lies, I think, takes in different forms, but it's very common when it is when you compliment someone for their work.
Yes.
Trying to motivate them, trying to keep them moving forward, right? So even though their performance in their work, I would say, it's not really that good,
right?
But you have to say something to motivate them. So, yeah, I'll say you did a great job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You're doing well.
It's
keep it up.
It's for good intentions.
Just good intentions.
Yes. Okay. What about you, Zue? Anything you want to share?
I don't usually compliment others.
I know, you don't want people to compliment you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Me too.
Yes. All right, you guys.
Thank you so much, everyone, for staying with us up to this point. Today, we discussed the concept of white lies and their influence on the development of trust in our lives. So, overall, do you think, like, white lies and a white intention filter, are they good or not? The white lies,
In fact, it helps them to be more, I guess, careful of what they do and a little more polite. So generally, mostly are harmless.
Communication lower and mebow if you think it's in a trust issue, my pet not that body carry
or Shila. Pet the nata, Shiva, Chila Lushin, and Nene Holy, we're old enough, Nene, Diaria, white lights, or the Tilarave. So they're really not that harmless.
So, Theory, how old are you right now?
I'm actually 19.
19, so DRT, Amipia, who alone it on the white lights.
I know too. You know, I know better now.
Yeah, I would be concerned if you still believe in all that. Yeah.
I think they know too. That's the work.
Anymore
at this age.
Does your parents still do it?
No more.
Okay.
So, how do you think? Is it good or not?
It's good or not from white?
Well, it's a good, like, if your parents
still
yeah, if they still do it, like, do you think it'll be a good thing, or do you think it's like concerning if they're still telling you white lies?
Okay, so I think they have every right to keep telling me the white lies.
Right.
I don't see it as a fault.
Okay.
I don't see, yeah, it's an issue for me.
Mm-hmm.
But at some point, I think they should stop.
Telling
white lies.
All right.
Because this doesn't make any sense. Doesn't work out for their kids anymore. They learn everything.
Yeah.
When they're 15, you know, by the time you reach, I would say, you know, 15 years old.
Yeah.
They learn all of those.
Yeah.
These are not.
Yeah. Yeah. That's when common sense starts really building up.
Yeah.
So understandable. All right.
At the end of the day, it's just something, a little fun memory for us to look back on. You know, we can laugh about it, have conversation about it like we are right now.
Mm. Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, some people might think they're just communicating like using white lines for a well-intentioned reason. But on the other hand, some white lines are more than harmful than someone think.
Yeah, I think sometimes there's a, you know, clash, like understanding conflict. Yeah. Even today, especially when you're adult, there's still, I don't know how to put that, it's a stereotypes of white lies.
Yes.
Right? For instance, Mejide.
Ah. Right. I hear that every day.
Yeah. Yeah. How do you take it? Is it real or, I don't know, it's a fancy?
No. My mom depends on me for financial support, so she doesn't really have that much power over me.
Mm? Girl power.
Yes, girl. Okay. What about you, Zoe? Does your mom still tell you white lies till now?
Sometimes.
Really?
I told her, you might get struck by a lightning.
Still?
I am still afraid of that.
No, oh. But does she still say that, like, to you?
Kind of.
Oh gosh, okay.
We are doing it with AUY. So thank you guys for joining us. We will be back next weekend.
Yes, and we're gonna have more special guests from AUY. So I'm so glad you guys are here today. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for coming us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right. It's a pleasure being here.
All right.
MI Radio. Hear it. Feel it. Love it.